Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Being able to tag an expense or an item as billable to a customer is a great feature that's available in the Plus plan. It helps you to ensure that you recoup all expenses that you would like to be charging to your customers and tag inventory items to particular customers as well, which can be great for tracking accurate costing and also remembering where things have gone. If you'd like to see what features are available in the different plans, click the link below. Table will pop up with everything in it. And then now let's go into the sample company and mark some expenses billable. Okay, we'll start in the sample company having a look at a bill that we prepared earlier for Tanya. So we'll pop up to this backwards clock here, open up the bill from Tanya, where we tagged one of these fountains as billable to Amy. So when we purchased these fountains from Tanya, we decided that one of them was going to go to Amy and we tagged it right here. You can see here the billable, check, uncheck. So we'll save and close this. And then we're going to use an expense for an example. So we'll go now, We're going to go to Chin's Oil and Gas. Now let's say that we're using our MasterCard to pay $250 for automotive fuel, but we want to charge $50 of this to Amy. So what we're going to do is separate this out and say $200 is here. $50 of this is billable towards Amy. And Let's make a comment in the description field that will come into our invoice. Additional fuel for mowing back part of Sanctuary. How's that? Maybe it was some extra thing that we did for Amy. We will save and close this. Now let's have a look at our profit and loss before we go any. We can see we have sales of 6,600. We have cost of goods sold of 3,550. We have fuel of 250. So now we'll pop back here and we'll create an invoice for Amy. Amy's Bird Sanctuary. Look, these two items here, they pop up for us to add to our invoice. So let's add them all. We have the quartz fountain at $2,500, and we have the additional fuel for mowing the back part of the sanctuary for $50. Great idea to enter those details as you're tagging them. I always think I'm going to remember things, and I don't. Now, this fountain cost us $2,500. We're not going to sell it to Amy for $2,500. So let's sell it to Amy for $5,000. If you watched the inventory example, that was the amount that we decided was our selling price. And we'll save and close this. Now let's go back and have a look at our income statement. The sales have gone up by $5,000, even though that invoice was for $5,050. The cost of goods sold has increased to take into account the cost of the $2,500 fountain. And look at this, our fuel cost has dropped by $50 because we took the $50 from Amy out of our expense. Isn't that amazing? That's such a great tool to have to be able to tag those things as billable, not forget them, and then instantly see the impact on your profit and loss. Now, we manually adjusted that price for Amy when we sold the fountain. There's a markup option that I'd like to explore with you next. Let's pop up into the settings. Under expenses, I'm going to pop in here, and we have the option to make expenses and items billable with a markup default, let's put 50%. Okay, now here's another little checkmark box. Track billable expenses and items as income or not. So that $50 in fuel deducted from the expense because I hadn't checked this box. If I checked this box here, then I would have the option to have that billable expense come up as income. But I chose not to do that, which is why the fuel amount was deducted, $50 was deducted from that fuel expense. Hope that makes sense. So now let's save this. We're done. Okay, now we're going to go to Tanya's. Or maybe we'll send her a purchase order, but we're going to go to Tanya's. And we're going to get some rocks. So we'll delete these couple of items that have pre-filled. I'm going to buy rocks. And we're going to buy 250 of them at $10 a rock. And then we're going to say that they're billable to, why not Amy again?
Now you can see here our markup percentage that we just set of 50% has come up automatically. And a grayed out number here of 3750 shows that what we will be billing to Amy. Now, if for some reason we wanted to change this right now, we could. We could change this to 100, and then we'd be able to see that we'd be charging Amy 5,000. So as with all of these options, they pre-fill, they're fantastic, they save you thinking on the bulk of your transactions, but on those cases where you want to change something, you can do so. So I'm going to leave this with the markup of 50% and save and close. So now I'm going to go and create the invoice for Amy, another one. Her place is going to look spectacular. And we can see here we have the option to add this billable expense with the markup on it. So let's add it in. And we have the Garden Rocks with a 50% markup. So I'm going to save this and I'm going to show you what Amy's invoice looks like, because you might not want Amy to know what this markup is. So we have a look here to print or preview. We can see here, Garden Rocks, $250 at a rate of $15. Fantastic. That 50% markup has come in by default. It's included in the line and it all looks fantastic. So we could print it, download it, save and send it to Amy, but we're going to save and close because we're in the sample company. Let's have a quick look at our profit and loss and see what's changed. Our sales of product income have increased from the rocks that we sold, as has the cost of goods sold because the rocks came out of inventory. So once again, these behind the scenes transactions and making sure your records are up to date constantly, which is really part of what I love about using, well, any software. I tend to prefer QuickBooks Online, but any software will help you to keep your records in order and you can tell up to the minute how your business is doing. Now, if you combine this feature with the option to mark your time as billable, hopefully you will be able to fully utilize all your expenses, all your time, capture it, send it out to all your clients, and increase the profitability of your business. So be sure to check the blog post out so that you can see what features there are, which ones work best for your business, and click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again. Cheers.